Hey, what's going on, guys, and welcome back. So I'm going to be going over one of my newest pieces of kit that I've got here, and that is the YHM Turbo K. Now, I know it's been in a couple of the other running gun videos that I've done, but it actually just cleared and got out of NFA jail a couple of days ago, so I'm going to be seeing this a lot more on my fighting carbine here, being my 11.5-inch build that you see me running majority of the time. Now, a common misconception that you're going to get out of these is that they're going to actually completely quiet the gunshot, and that is just absolutely not the case. These are still incredibly loud even when you throw them melee into your gun, but it does take the sting off of things for you a little bit. It's not going to be causing damage to your hearing. Now, I know Warrior Poet Society, he had a whole thing come out talking about how he doesn't like running cans because he wants that fire-breathing dragon on the end of his gun. He wants to scare whoever is outside. Truth being told, I don't really care about who's outside. Somebody's breaking into my house, I'm going to take them out. Somebody else comes in behind them, I'm going to have them as well. Wife will be back behind me calling 911, doing whatever is necessary to kind of get help on the way. But until that happens, I'm going to be fighting whoever it is that's in my house out and trying to put a stop to that threat. Now, he was talking about how auditory exclusion kind of kicks in and you don't really hear it and all that. And yeah, while that's the case, auditory exclusion is real. You have these little hairs that are inside of your ear, and what happens is the sound waves moves across those hairs, and it's what causes the actual noise that your ears or your brain picks up. Now, once those little hairs experience a lot of trauma, they kind of tend to lay down, they never stand back up, and that's just how you kind of incur more and more and more hearing loss. So even though you have auditory exclusion, you are still suffering damage to your hearing if you're running one of these. Your ears don't close themselves off to the noise that's going on. Your brain just kind of shuts it out, kind of like your brain sends adrenaline to areas and it shuts out the pain if you ever get injured. You don't really feel in the moment, but excruciating pain afterwards. So, same kind of thing with your ears. Silencers are very important on your home defense, vehicle defense, any kind of other thing, weapons. That being said, I kind of wanted to go to the smallest kind of configuration that I could possibly find, and that's why I went with the Turbo K. So a couple of the things that you want to pay attention to is, one, exactly how much suppression that you actually are getting out of it. Even though, yes, suppressors don't take the noise away, they still do significantly protect your hearing more than if you had just an actual gunshot going around. I do not recommend running these without hearing protection or any kind of cam, no matter how big it is, on a 5.56 without hearing protection, because it is still over that damaging threshold to your hearing. So run it with a head, any kind of ear protection, whether it be muffs, earplugs, whatever you can. But the time come and you weren't able to, it's not going to completely destroy your hearing or wreck it, like for instance what this cherry bomb would do if you torch this thing off indoors. It would most definitely damage your hearing, or even a flash hider. So in this video, I'm going to kind of go over the flash suppression side of it, let you guys see exactly how much flash suppression you're getting out of this tiny package. You notice the actual size of this can. I believe with the Q Plan B mount, it's right at 5 inches in overall length, and it only adds about 3.5 inches of length onto your gun. So it keeps everything a nice, short, tight, compact package. So the first thing that I've done is I went kind of over the flash suppression with the camera light on. That way you guys can actually see the gun shooting, see it cycling. And you can see exactly how small the jet, there's a little bit of a flame or jet that comes out the front of this camera and around goes off. But exactly how small and insignificant that is. And then I also did it again with the camera light off. And then we also filmed through nods. We filmed both the can shooting and a YHM QD mini Phantom flash hider as well. Now the flash hider is a little bit smaller, so you're going to have a little bit more flash coming out of that than you would the full size Phantom. But that being said, it's still not bad, and both under nods and under the regular light, you can definitely tell that this is significantly less than what your bare muzzle is. Both guns shot were 11.5-inch barrels. Both guns used, I believe my buddy was using 55 grain Wolf in his. It might have been Federal, but I used Wolf 55 grain steel case in mine, so a very dirty round as well. Usually those are more of a flash anyways. So stay tuned for that. It's coming up. Just let me know what you guys think. First up is going to be the shots with the camera light on. All right, now a couple in the berm. All right, and bear with me. I know you can't really see me right now, but just kind of pay attention for the flash. So this is going to be with the camera light off, so you can see the flash signature. It's just going to be into the berm. I'm also going to be firing in the direction camera. All right. That's with a flash hider. Alrighty guys, in conclusion, it's just one of the first of many different types of tests I'm actually running with this. Also gonna be doing long term on this gun, pretty much being on there running a suppressor the rest of its life. Since before the suppressor came, obviously I couldn't shoot it every day, so we weren't really able to make that possible. But now this will pretty much live on here, so paint that I'm actually have put on this. This is Krylon metal can paint, just green, nothing special. No, it's not gonna hold up, but kind of what I want as far as that goes. So yeah, it's been a good can. I've had it for a while now. It's been sitting in FA job, but perks being friends with your SOT guys is he comes out and shoots with me a lot. I go out and shoot with him a lot, so he comes, brings the can, and I'm able to kind of run it whenever he was out here. Got a second one in as well. I'll do a comparison. It's a Resonator K, the 30 cal version of this. Kind of give you guys an idea in comparison of how these two cans work in conjunction with each other. I can only really explain noise wise how they sound. The Resonator K is a little bit louder, obviously it's a little bit larger of a bore, so you allow more gas to escape out the front. Back pressure on both of them is really good. Don't really have much of a problem with gas in the face, nothing to really notice, even with high volumes of fire. These cans are also very rugged, so if you guys are in the market for one, I would very highly suggest these guys, the Yankee Hill Turbo and Resonator line of cans. Very versatile cans at a very good price. After tax stamp, SOT fees and everything, I think it was right around $690 with this guy here. And very affordable cans that get you into the market. And they're full auto rated. I've gotten this one glowing red hot off of a select fire lower and didn't have any problems with it. But if you guys do have any questions, drop them down in the comment section below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, happy shooting.
Fight!
I never forget. It was only a few years ago you tried to blame me, girl. You did me wrong. You should know that I can't forget. No. Foreigners pulled on the side of that highway. We fighting because of a text. I can't forget.
Problem.
No. Thought you was by my side. That was one big lie. I cannot forget. Shake it to the side, fill up my appetite. She knows she does it right. Rich man, poor choice tonight. She band-aids all my lies. Yeah, I changed. How can I stay the same? You love to just complain and never feel my pain. Left me out in the rain, put my whole name to shame. Used to live in my veins. Yeah, I don't feel the same. You love to play these games, push my buttons insane. Turned into a stain, washed up won't go away. Made me question my faith, almost blew out my brains. Jumped in front of a train, thank God that I was safe. I never forget.